It's Absolute Radio at the Virgin Media V Festival, and here's Norman Cook now. Hello.
Good afternoon, good evening.
You don't know what time it is?
I know what time it is in Ibiza.
Because you just arrived.
I literally just landed, yeah.
So what was it, EasyJet and then the coach?
Yeah, something like that, yeah.
And you were just telling me, I don't know if you will tell me this again down a microphone, that you renewed your wedding vows yesterday.
Yes, me and Zoe, my wife, have been married 10 years and we met in Ibiza, so we thought we'd go back and celebrate it. I've got another ring, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow, it is, and it's, is it expensive, that? I mean, the other one's looking a bit tarnished.
A gentleman never asks.
Yeah, no, I can bite in and usually, I can usually bite and tell. that's great
that's,
news.
That's what everyone says about you.
that's great news. So is it a big do?
No, we just kind of did it with a load of friends on the beach at sunset, because we met in Ibiza 11 years ago, so it's kind of like, yeah, we go back every year for a pilgrimage.
Who did you get to do the disco?
Ed from the Chemicals.
That's good. That
of course.
Not just someone out of the Yellow Pages.
Well, he played at the wedding, so we thought it was fitting that he played 10 years later.
And are you going to be a dad again?
Hopefully, yes.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Knock on van.
Have
yes.
you got the DVD of the scan and all that?
Not for the likes of you, no. No, we've got all those 3D pictures.
Really, they do that now,
scary.
Do they?
It looks like something like Alien 2 or something.
And how are you with names? Are you?
That's strictly hush hush.
I think Jeff is a lovely name. It's gone out
Jeff,
of fashion,
okay.
But
Jeff Cook. Yeah, I can see that.
Jeff Cook sounds like a plumber, doesn't it? So, which of your many aliases are you here under this weekend?
Tonight, Matthew, I will be mainly Fatboy Slim.
Okay.
We sort of had the BPA album out, but I'm not. When I DJ, I kind of seem to mutate into Fatboy Slim. As soon as I go on stage and put the shirt on, I seem to be Fatboy Slim rather than Norman or the chairman of the BPA.
Do you think of...
I am supposed to be promoting the Brighton Port Authority album, which is called I Think We're Going to Need a Bigger Boat, available in record stores soon.
It's an interesting project, though, that you've assembled
now.
You've assembled a posse, the Brighton Port Authority.
Yeah, well, it was our long-lost album of collaborations with people who'd ended up around my house. Over the years, which we never ever kind of finished. It was quite a sort of drunken affair.
So you get them drunk and then you make them sign something saying they're going to come back
and
collaborate.
I get
you.
Them drunk, then I lure them back to my house with the promise of sexual exploits, and then get them in the studio, but then promptly forget about it. But my engineer just found a load of tapes and said, you know, listen to them, and said, actually, they're quite good and we should do something. So it's the unreleased, long lost, it's like my Smile album.
Yeah.
You know, the long lost...
And on the front as well, it looks a bit like, I don't know, like a gallery of convicts or something, the posters.
Well, that was kind of, that was kind of the thing.
A wanted poster.
It was kind of, the whole album's a bit of a rogues gallery, frankly.
Yeah. And have you been doing lots of festivals over the summer?
Yeah. I'm just coming to the end of summer season. But yeah, I mean, we started in Japan and then did Glastonbury and we've been doing Europe. It's quite funny getting here. It's like, oh, pendulum again.
When was the first time you ever got behind any disco decks? Were you ever a mobile DJ back in the day?
Oh, yeah. The first time I did it was just a party, and then I kind of enjoyed doing it. And then, we used to do the Tequila Mobile Roadshow around Red Hill, where I lived, and we did, like, college discos, pubs, weddings. I did a funeral.
I cut my teeth doing,
because I wasn't old enough to play in nightclubs.
Yeah.
This was when I was 16.
Yeah.
And
so
for 2 years, we just did sort of functions. And
how are you getting your gear about if you're only 16?
My mate had an estate car, and we used to put the decks in the back.
Yep.
But yeah, no, I mean, I definitely cut my teeth being a mobile DJ.
Yeah. And then who'd have thought you'd go from 60th wedding anniversaries to like 60,000 people. I'm sure you've DJed for that many people in the past.
Yeah, I mean, it's quite weird because the basic thing is the same. You've got two decks and you play records
and
try and make people dance and smile. So, yeah, I mean, the basic premise of it hasn't changed a lot.
It's you don't even have to get them doing special dances like the conga or Oops Upside Your Head or anything.
Oh, you
like
want
that.
To see some of those European festivals, you can make them do anything.
And I was wondering, how close do you think you are to being made the Mayor of Brighton?
There was talk of it. I don't know if it was through official channels or just like the local newspaper, but I'm not cut out for politics.
Hey, but you must be close to being given the key to the city then.
I think I don't have to pay my parking tickets.
And in terms of stuff, are you BPA for now? You're the captain of the BPA, right?
Chairman of the BPA, but by default.
Yeah.
At the end of summer, I'm going back to Ibiza after this for the closing parties, and then I'm back in the studio as Fatboy Slim, I think.
Okay. It's been
obviously
a while,
gearing up for the baby. I don't really want to be on the road too much. No. Mixed kind of, yeah. So, no, I'll be in the studio. I've got a few remixes and, yeah, and hopefully a new Fatboy Slim album.
Have you got your Freak Power coat in the cupboard still? Have you still got that?
It's firmly still in the cupboard, yeah. I heard they reformed without me and didn't tell me.
No.
Yeah. No, they did. They reformed and did some gigs without me and wondered why I was a bit miffed. But, no, bless him, no, I don't think that'll happen again.
And you got your House Martins Aaron knit sweater in the cupboard still?
Well, no, funny enough, I did actually get together with all the House Martins a couple of months back.
They re-released the album, didn't they?
Yeah, the 25th anniversary of the album. They re-released it and they got us together to do an interview, which is quite funny because we hadn't all been in the same room for literally about 20 years.
And how was that?
It was great. It was just like seeing your old mates. Because the thing is, what I've always said about the House Martins is like, it wasn't the like when you lose your virginity. It was not necessarily the best, but it meant a lot.
Yeah.
So it wasn't the best band I've been or the most happy I've been with the music I did. But yeah. In terms of like, that was the first time we did all these things, you know, the first time we played festivals and we're on the TV. So we all went through that together and we all remember that we were looking at each other going, can't believe it.
I think for bespectacled men of a certain age with a penchant for knitwear, you will always occupy a very special place in our hearts.
Thank you.
Which must be very strange to those generations of clubbers who've actually grown up with you now.
What I find is if you hang on to it long enough, it'll stick around, it'll come round again.
Do you reckon?
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for chatting to us. Good luck with the BPA.